Friends, now we are going to talk about certain specified services which are exempt under GST law and those services which are related to transportation of passenger. Why? Because if I am traveling in a bus or I am traveling through a motor vehicle or I am taking an aircraft, I am traveling through air, in that case I should know, right, if I have to pay GST or not. So what we are going to do is we will see if I'm traveling through different modes of transportation, in that case whether GST is levied or not. What I mean to say is whether it is in exempted services, those are specified under exempted services or not. Let us first start with aircraft. If I travel from say Mumbai to Goa by an aircraft, will GST be applicable? The answer is yes. For air travel, there is no exemption, GST is levied, except in one situation. What is it? If you are traveling to or you are traveling from any of the northeastern states, in that case, your GST will not be levied. What are they? Sikkim, Manipur and things like that. We will talk about all the list of states. But if you are traveling or to or from, that means, say, for example, you are traveling from Mumbai to any northeastern states. In that case also GST will not be levied. Similarly, if you are traveling from such northeastern state to Mumbai, then also your GST will not be levied. Let us quickly go through the list of states which are specified. The list of states are Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Sikkim or Tripura. Plus one more, what is it? Bagdogra, located in West Bengal. Okay, so if I am in general, if I am taking any flight, on the flight tickets I will have to pay GST. Suppose my flight ticket is say 5000, I will have to pay the applicable GST along with that 5000 rupees. But if I am taking flight from or to any of the states that we have discussed, in that case GST will not be levied. So friends, we have discussed one mode of transportation, right, which is air. Now, let us talk about transportation through railways. That means if I want to travel from one place to another by using a rail, in that case whether it is covered under exempted services or not. So friends, in general, railway can also be classified into multiple baskets, right? There can be a general rail which is run by Indian Railways. Then there can be a metro rail, monorail, tramways. There are different names or different categories of railway services, right? If I am availing any of these services, that means railways, monorail, tramways or metro rail, any of the four services, in that case GST is not levied. Why? Because it is covered under the exempted services. That means if suppose I have purchased a railway ticket from say West Bengal to Mumbai, I want to travel from West Bengal to Mumbai by way of rail. In that case, on the railway ticket, I don't need to pay any GST. So what we have discussed, railways, tramways, metro rails or monorail, in all those four cases, GST is not levied because it is covered under the exempted services. But there is only one exception. What is it? The exception is, if in railways you are traveling in first class or you are traveling in any AC coaches, in that case, it is not covered under exempted services. That means in those cases, GST will have to be levied and you will have to pay GST. That means if suppose I am traveling in AC second class, in that case also GST will be levied. That means in any AC coaches or in the first class coaches, you will have to pay GST. The reason is the government wants to exempt it only those services which is used by public at large, right? And generally in railways, a majority chunk of the railway services is used by those people who travel in non-AC coaches. So if you are traveling in non-AC coaches, GST will not be levied. But if you are traveling in AC coaches or you are traveling in first class, in that case GST will be levied. So what we have discussed, in general, railway services, metro rail services, monorail services or tramways, in all these four cases, are covered under exempted services and therefore GST will not be levied. But in case of railways, there is one exception. What is it? If you have booked your tickets for a first class coach or if you have booked your tickets for an AC coach, in that case you will have to pay GST because those are excluded from the exempted services. So friends, in case of transportation of passenger, we have discussed two situations: if we are traveling through air or if we are traveling by way of any of the railway modes. Now let us talk about the third situation. What is it? If I am providing services of transporting passenger by any river or through sea, what does it mean? There are a lot of inland waterways like river Ganga, river Saraswati and things like that. There are a lot of rivers and there are a lot of ferries which runs on those rivers, right? Basically the services which is provided by the ferry operators, will that be livable to taxes? The answer is no. For all the inland waterways movement, GST is not levied. So if any ferry is running from one place to another and I have availed those services, I don't need to pay any additional GST because those are exempted services. Similarly, if there is any transportation of passenger services which is being provided from one place to another within India by way of a vessel, how is it possible to transfer from one place to another within India in a vessel? The answer is, suppose I want to travel from Andaman and Nicobar, Port Blair, I want to travel from Port Blair to Havelock Island and I have taken a government ferry. Okay, I have taken a government vessel in which I am traveling from Port Blair to Havelock Island. In that case, whether I need to pay GST? The answer is no. But at the same time, if there is another private tour operator which runs a boat which says I am going to make you travel to different island and then I am finally going to drop you to Havelock Island, in that case GST will be levied. The point which I am trying to make over here is, in general, if you are traveling through vessel from one place to another in India, you don't need to pay GST. But if it is for tourism purpose, GST is levied. If you want to use for normal movement, no GST is levied. But if you are using it for tourism purpose, GST is levied. Now let us talk about the fourth and the most commonly used circumstances, which is road transport. In case of road transportation, there are a lot of ways in which I can travel by road. What are those ways? First option which is available to me is if I travel through any bus. The second option is I can take any Uber or Ola kind of a cab. The third option which is available to me is I can take any yellow taxi, which is a metered taxi which runs on meters, right? And the fourth option that is available to me is I can take any auto rickshaw, right, including lot of e-rickshaw or toto, which is commonly called as, right? So there are a lot of options available to me. Are those services which is being provided levable to tax? The answer is no. All of them are covered under exempted services except one. What are they? The services provided by Ola and Uber. So those radio taxis are taxable under GST law, but apart from that, all the services which is provided by any bus or which is provided by any auto rickshaw or e-rickshaw or any of those kind of things are exempted from GST law. Clear? So only Ola and Uber kind of a services are taxable. Apart from that, all the other services are exempted under GST law.